Don't you guys love the sound of this? It's one of those really cool chimes. The sound just brings me joy. So, I don't know, I like to play it before we begin.
Hi, Donna here. Okay, this is another painting that's like probably three paintings, but over time just painted over. And again, because it had a dark background when I was looking at it, it just looks really muted and I have some good colors going right now. So I thought I would bring it a little more to life. I'm gonna start, I think, with the sky, where I've got some white on the brush. And I think it just wants to be a little lighter. So I'm gonna see what happens if I load some blues and the lightness. And just go lighter with the sky. There again, there's some texture on here because it was another painting. So the texture is just gonna come in. We're gonna let it. I'm gonna let some of what was already on there stay there. There's some paper texture here that we'll play with too. I'm getting behind it. I'm using the dry brush almost like just like using the brush to brush the paint more into the canvas so that the texture in the background is gonna show, but not as much on the brush strokes. Going over these flowers for now. Again, just to get that lightness behind what's already on there, because it had a pretty dark background before. I like texture in a painting. You can just take any paper, like newsprint or any paper, and just use some Elmer's glue and glue it on with a lot of water and let it dry. And that's one of the ways to get a texture. Now that I have the color down, I have to come back and see. I'm gonna go with a little more white. Still want that lightened up a bit. I'm gonna come back in here. I'm adding more paint, then I'll kind of push it in. I think this is gonna get a little more blue over here. I like the way that blue is showing up. So I'm putting it on, and I'm gonna kind of like a brush massage it in. That's what we'll be doing. I'm gonna start with that. Whoopsie, no, it's over. Yeah, sometimes it's a mess. I'm gonna start with pushing this blue in, because it's got more color. I'm hitting the top edge too. I like when the canvas goes over the edge. And I'm gonna carry that blue out. Stand back here so I can see what you're seeing. Now, again, I wanted like a field of flowers when I started this. Let's see if that's doable. I've got paint all over me. I'm gonna go with the blossom of the flowers first. Using a thin, flat brush. Kind of what we painted over with some of the purple. I like those long blooms. I see a little more purple here. Add some yellow. I these kind of go with the texture because there's this crinkly line going along here. Filling that in. And then I'm going to add some of the same color, but a different kind of thing over here. Add some bigger flowers with the double loaded brush. It's the way I like to do it. And then I'm going to do some blue because there was some blue already on there, but I'm going to use the round brush. And take some bright blue. I'm gonna come in here where there's already some blue, and I'm just gonna dot in some blue. What are those hyacinths that look like that? All the nature things just inspire, like all the shapes in nature are so amazing, right? Do you ever like stop and look at just one bloom, one tiny bloom? I spend a lot of time in the forest and I love to look low and just look at the tiny blooms and their details. Okay, then I'm gonna go with a deeper purple and some white. I think these are going to be rounder petals. Let's see. Maybe here. Oh, here. This is going to be the middles. Sometimes you start doing one thing and another thing happens. You just go with the flow. I did want to. Oh, what are those called? Lilac-y things. Lilac-y things. I don't know the names of any of the flowers. I just appreciate how beautiful they are. Put you there. This is getting a little muddy. There's purple and blue, so it's looking a little muddy. So I'm going to ditch this brush. Go grab another one. Clean brushes, helpful when things start to look muddy. Do a reload. I think that these might like these little purples, middles. So if the paint is really thick, it's fun because it leaves a texture on the canvas. This is making its own little kind of flower. And we just let that happen. That's the fun of it. You change the brush color, the flower changes the nature of itself. You're gonna notice that in nature, no two sames. That's fun, let's do more of that. I'm gonna mix it with some purple over here. I do see where I'm kind of following some of the what was already on here, just kind of going with that. That's got something's got to happen in there. I'm not sure what yet. Oh, and then there's going to be this, but I'm saving that for last because it's going to be super fun. Okay, let's see. I want to save the best for last. What is that? Who does that? Save the best for last. I don't know where I learned that. Aren't we humans so funny? Our little habits and patterns and how we do things. And I wanted to give that a center. Same here. Nice, yummy center. Love the centers of flowers, they're so intricate. You ever stop and watch a bee like come into a flower? It's just so cool. Okay, this is gonna be more yellow. And we'll do some gold. This one. And I thought of daisies there, so I think I'm going to stay with the whole daisy thing. I'm looking for a daisy brush. A daisy brush will have a small head on it. Let's see. I'm going to find it. It's got to be a short brush. I'll try this one. I'm going to try this small one and see what happens here. I'm just going to load it up with white and a tiny hint of, do a tiny hint of yellow on it. And let's see if we can pop up some daisies. Oh, there we go. A little bit too much yellow on the brush. I'm going to go like that. And a little bit of yellow in the middle. The brush. I want there to be a lot, so I'm going to do some tinier ones. Sometimes daisies grow like in patches. Have you ever been in a patch of daisies? Oh my gosh, it's so fun. And then the wind blows and it's just like magic. You get to see the wind when the wind is blowing through the daisies. Oh, yeah. I have a cousin, and that's her favorite flower. And it's interesting when we love someone and know something that they love, how we can think of them when we see the something. So I think I'll just devote this little daisy patch to her. So now I'm going to stand back. Because there's all that daisy stuff happening, you don't want to just be stuck there. We're going to add a few more little daisies down here so the eye can wander down to some more daisies. That looks a little more random. A little tiny one over here. A little one over here in the corner that just wandered over. Notice this heart right here. I love to have some hearts sort of just sneaking in places in a painting. A little extra love vibe. I'm going to go with this blue here. I'm going to do some blue. And what color are we calling for? How about some pink? How about a little pink? I'll take this one. I'm stepping back to see where is the pink going to go. Another one over here. A random pink flower. Not all the way open. Ooh, reminds me of peony. My favorite. Everything's my favorite, you guys. I lie when I say something's my favorite, or it's true, and everything is my favorite. Okay, let me give it a little more depth. A little more pink. Can always go back in. Okay, last thing I'm going to do here, except I'm seeing this little mess right here that I want to add to. I see that this wants to be a little more color. There's blue underneath it, so it wasn't quite showing up. There we go. Now we see you. Okay, I'm gonna go with a little tiny brush with some yellow, just some bright yellow, school busy yellow. And I'm gonna dot the center of the daisies. Trying to keep the brush right on the paint on the edge of the brush. So it just kind of dots right off when you touch it. Sometimes that works, sometimes not so much. Okay, let's try. Here we go. I'm gonna give that a yellow center. I'm gonna go white in this one. One more color there. All right. Now we're gonna go with a dry brush. I'm looking for a dry brush. And I'm gonna hit the edges of these lovely blooms that are pinwheelish. And I'm thinking the color is going to be somewhere in the pinkish-orangish. Pinkish-orangish. Is that a color? All right. A little white. Again, I'm going to be mindful that the brush is not too wet. So it's sort of like a little bit of a test. So you hit these like top edges. And it's cool because the newsprint is showing underneath it, but you have the sense that it's some kind of a flower, some flowery thing. So there's orange. I'm going to go a little more pink on the next one. There's other colors in here, which makes it kind of fun. Again, I'm just trying to hit a top edge, just where it just the lighter part. I think I'm gonna go with a little more yellow on the next one. Bright yellow. Wanna hit the yellow on this one. There's still other colors coming through. It's picking up some of that white on the edge. Should we do a blue one? Let's do a blue one. I'm gonna use another brush. And go with the blue. This one, let's make this one blue. Nice bright blue. And then, let's see, how about, I'm just looking at the color to see if what I need to repeat maybe. Maybe a little more of this purpley goldy stuff. This was the metallic. I'm gonna add a little white to it. There is some of that here already. Yeah. Picking up those edges, a little bit of texture. Yeah. Okay, I'm seeing something happening there. Now I'm gonna go in and do some stems. And I'm gonna use this angle brush because it's kind of thin. And I think it'll let me double load to make the stems. We're gonna see. So I'm putting some white on one side. And I like the metallic green on one side. And then I'm gonna do the darker green on the other side. This paint's a little thick, so I don't know. We'll see what happens. You never know. It's the beauty of the whole thing. We never know. So I'm going to come in here and I'm going to make this stem come down. I'm going to find where. And then I'm just going to, since I'm not putting it in first, I'm just going to find a line. It's dragging a nice little bit of color on the edge. I'm going to take these guys here. And then I'm going to try to continue those down. So you kind of see that they're moving. I'm gonna give this one a stem. Oh, my brush needs more paint. What did I do? No idea. Oh yeah, this metallic and then some green on the other side. Oh, I forgot that dude. Okay, there we go. And now I'm gonna go here to get these guys some, so it'll bring them up front. These daisy guys. If my brush gets, the line gets too thin, I'm gonna like kind of wipe off the brush and start again. So we'll see how this goes. I feel like these might be fun to put in. A little too heavy on white. Metallic, more green. Okay. So I'm not gonna do a full line here so that it looks like it's holding the blue. Y'all, I don't know what I'm doing really. This is what I see, right? What would you see if you were doing this? What would you see? What do you see? And the thing about art is it's just a way of expressing and playing. There's so many ways to express and play in the world. I mean, maybe you build sandcastles. Maybe you bake cakes. Maybe you make sounds or music. I love to paint to music and sound. Unfortunately, there are licensing things on YouTube. So if you're watching this and you are a musician and you want to give us some music, I would love that. So I'm following some of the lines that are already here. Shaking them down so the things look like they're growing. I don't mind if they're floating either, though, just to say. It's all preference. These guys are gonna have a line in them somewhere. I do like how this green is coming through those. Yeah. I feel like I need a little bit more on that stem there. It's kind of fun to get lost in a painting. Just let it lead you where it leads you. And the thing is, if you're doing a painting yourself and you haven't painted, so what? Just paint something and then paint over it. Do it again and again. Make it fun. All right, I feel like that's a lot of blue, so I'm gonna add a little green in there. Maybe a stem that'll come, but I gotta root it in. There we go. All right, watch it here. Getting a little crazy. You know, less is more. No, it isn't. Okay, I'm gonna step back and go, oh my god, that's a wildflower garden. We have master gardeners in our neighborhood, and in the springtime, I feel like when I'm walking down the street, I see gardens like this. My little mind translated. So thank you to all the master gardeners in my neighborhood for the inspiration, and thank you all for hanging out with me and while I paint. Have a very blessed day. Notice what you're noticing, see what you're seeing. And if there's something that you love that inspires you and you want to, I don't know, message me a photo of it or something that I could see that would inspire a painting, I'm all over that. That'd be fun. Okay, that's it. Have a great day.